Hello, Nader here. Welcome back to Power of Exile. We're playing in the hardcore solo soulbound Legacy League as a Flameblast Elementalist. And in between episodes, I had a little bit of crafting. Had this savant rope of the walrus in my stash still. It came with the 30% to cold resistance. Crafted a nice 55% increased energy shield on top. Gave it some quality and that made it better than our old Contagious Vestments. The energy shield will be from 114 to 205. That's plus 90, that's nearly double. And all we did was give up 64 life for 90 ES. And net result is that we gained a couple more effective HP. And that the energy shield is now a little bit larger. So that is nice. Also plus 5 cold resist. And after rolling a couple of Jewelers Orbs, we got 5 sockets, and then a couple of fuses later, it was 5 linked. I got lucky on the rolls there. So now we have a Flame Blast with faster casting, controlled destruction, chance to ignite, and new, and I spoke about it last time, fire penetration. So things that have fire resist are less resistant to our efforts to murder them, which is useful. So next episode, Doresso. We got rid of the eye, then of course we sockets, anarchy, ambush, and warband leak stones, and then we start dreaming. I am the vessel, the sword of the king. It was here in the pits of the universe that I made my name, killing raven dogs and wild boars before I could even be considered a man. Quirky why that thing was standing there. Freezes you and detonates corpses. So against foes that don't have any fire resistance, of course, we're just gonna deal more damage. And especially against bosses, which are naturally resistant to curses, flammability is not gonna do much. Excuse me. Flammability is not gonna do much, but resistance penetration definitely helps a lot there. Well, say it's not gonna do a lot, but it's gonna be less effective. It's only gonna be 40% as effective as it normally is. Okay, and there's some brine rods. Okay. And then we just push forward, and I don't think I want a big staff. Let's just push forward to what we got. The arenas for caster like us are the least favorite matchup, just because no close confines, not a lot of space to walk around, definitely not something that we are naturally strong in. On the other hand, we do quite some damage and it does group monsters together, so you can look at that as an advantage as well. It's the whole I'm not locked in them, not locked in here with them, but they are locked in here with me kind of approach of looking at things. For now, that is probably the best way to put it. Because I live and they don't. So refresh our golems here. And then let's keep heading this way. And another one. Okay, looks like we're on the right track here. It's always two closed arenas before the final boss arena. Some blues. As long as there are not large groups of elemental resistant things in here, I'm fine. Also a selection of skills that all just want to level up means we can just click and level and not pay too much attention about what level do things have to be specifically. Okay. And That's the last stage. Exactly. The decoy totem, that's the skill we don't use a lot. Some more life. We're getting close again to 2500 that we were at before. Shrouded ones, let's take a step back. Another highborn bow. That's 2 6 socketed items in one run. I definitely approve of that. And this is the final arena. Okay. This, as I said, not entirely the ideal matchup for us, but this we got it. They do quite some damage here. Let's just force our energy shield to start recharging here. Make sure our mana remains maxed and at least we have mind over matter in our favor. Okay, we lost one golem, that was not very useful. And that's that. Yeah. So, yeah, that was a little closer than I would have liked it to be. Might as well just empty our pockets now and then move forward. Also, it's a nice way to make the rest show shut up. Exactly like that. The fight with Daressa himself, probably gonna be a bit easier. Whoa. Wait, bleeding though. But yeah, fight with Daressa is probably gonna be a bit easier. Oh. For the simple fact that it's just gonna be one foe to run from, which is manageable instead of just an arena full that is a little less manageable. Another Sylvan's Rope, might as well have a look. It might be better. Oh, elemental reflect. yeah, totem, please fix that for me. Thank you. Now the elemental equilibrium definitely works very nicely for us, just piercing the fire resist. So even a not really supported scorching ray totem can take out rares when it needs to. Yeah. And there's the exits. Nice. It's a 56 area, so we're just one level above the area. That's good. That's Armrio's bell. And he's dead. Anything useful? Not very likely, given that he's more of a, was it more of a duelist, I suppose. Doesn't really matter. If he dies, it's good. We don't always need the good gear. For you. The addition of fire penetration boosted our mana usage from 12 to 18. It's a pretty large bonus. Ooh, another 6 sockets. And as a result, you now actually see the mana pool dropping down a bit in the more sustained fights. But the good thing is we have a mana flask that is specifically meant to keep that mana bubble filled up. It also kind of cop Moonlight a little bit as a health potion due to Mind Over Matter. So. But mana flasks are not a bad thing in this build. And having to use it, that's just good. Let's use the silence here to refresh our golems. Okay, let's guess that this is the right one. And the guess is correct because a Unix. Yep, good. Nice. Got them both with a single hit. And we are full on loot again. Okay. Anything that is potentially useful from the blue stuff? The spirit shield. Okay. And then up and down we go for more loot stashery. And I don't think anything else is truly upgraded, so let's keep pushing forward. We have an appointment with Daresso. Daresso will die. Don't think passion has been enough to claim crowns ever. But that might just be me misremembering history lessons, things like that. Okay, the final test. Can we defeat the King of Blades?
King of Swords is nothing.
The King of Swords.
For honor.
Okay, please do jump into the circle, and that was the first stage. I don't quite want to be there. Okay, that was a full hit. Just stage 10. Yep, got him in the edges again. Gotta pay attention not to step in the swords. Those are the most dangerous things in the entire arena here. Okay, and too bad, he's gonna heal up back to half, I think. Oh, last quarter, okay.
My lady.
Okay, angry Daresso, very angry Daresso. And there we are.
I'm sorry to have to break this to you, Daresso, but she's not real.
She's not real. Saw through the illusion, did we? And none of the other items is good for us. So that concludes the epic tale of the King of Swords and how we fell to a simple witch. And with that, we have a bit of an odd timing. It's only 13 minutes into the episode. Unable to connect to achievement server. Okay, that is getting interesting. Can we at least get down there and move over, or is the connection just getting awkward now? No, it's not. Okay, let's at least blow this one up, advance our story there. And yeah, let's actually turn this into a slightly extended video where we go after both Daresso and move forward into the Belly of the Beast. We can now enable our thingamajigs again, our League Stones, and then we push forward. Just hope that the achievement server thing was just a one-off weird hiccup. If not, at least we tried. Okay, Beyond, that's always fun, though. Beyond in the belly might not be the best of ideas. There's a magic item, random curse, sure. Let's take a step back and then we murder things from a distance. And then a little bit more there. And then everything is gone. Also including our golems. Man, they really do take quite a punishment. As of course intended, but still they take quite some punishment. That is of course in the age-old tradition of the goblin hero. The golems get bombarded to become heroes, not because they necessarily step forward out of bravery, but because I simply step backwards and leave them out on the front lines, whether they want to or not. Of course, a golem is replaceable, a witch is a little less replaceable. Okay, that ends. See, so it's nice that we didn't really have to push too far to discover it was a dead end. Yeah, bleeding. Let's cure that. Okay, now we got Piety after this. That is gonna be more interesting. A lot more interesting. On normal, we did pretty well. We just set her on fire, ran around a couple times, and she died. On cruel, she's gonna be more tanky. She's also gonna hurt more. Question is, can we still inflict enough damage on her to kill her even faster or as fast as before? Or is this gonna be a little bit more of a fair fight towards a Piety? Bone Queen. With some add-ons. Okay, come on, there you go. I think this is the Bone Queen. No, it wasn't. Looked like the way towards the Bone Queen. If it's not, then I'll just stick to the path here. It seems to head into the right direction. No. Having said that, it probably turns into a dead end. Yeah, of course. Then we just check out those little bits. Rep bands. Rep blades. War bands. Something. Okay, and that is the dead end as well. Golems survived the encounter, lucky for them. Okay, and this another big area, but no boss fights. All these areas that just get a little wider towards the end, they all remind me of the Bone Queen area. Just keep getting ready for a boss fight and then just running into regular mobs. Then of course I'll just wander blindly in against her next or not. Okay, more Bone Warriors at least. Does that mean I'm getting close? Yeah, I think she might have been in the back there. Yeah, especially with those corrupted beasts. Yeah, she's there. She was at the back. Oh, there you are. Boom. Okay, she is rather mobile as well. Being a Stygian. They are They do have speed as their ally. But and she's burning. That doesn't help her in any way. So at the end, I don't think there was a big treasure chest. Nope, nothing truly. But a large number of bone warped warriors that just crawl out of the floor, let themselves be exploded and give us some more XP. Experience is of course its own reward. Alright, one level above the area, harvest is probably going to be 57 if I remember correctly. So gaining another level would be nice just to have a small edge. Also, I made a small mistake there. It was this way and then to the top. Okay, then we go right, and then we go left. Well, we might end up doing a full clear of the area, just because navigation is difficult. Well, as I said, no, we're not really that far ahead of the leveling curve, so gaining some extra XP, some extra opportunities for loot, I really don't mind. I did quite some damage. Okay, that end. Yeah. Okay, we found it. So that is one little edge unexplored. That's good. We didn't do a complete full clear of the area. Okay, next up. Piety. Burnt miscreations. So just double check and we burned through all of our legacy stones. Okay, cool. And if I remember, once we're back at town, we'll just grab a couple extras. The other hand, doing the final level without legacy stones is not that bad a deal either. We got a rogue exile, we've got a warband pack here. That's just a nice little bonus. I think in normal we did Malakai with Tempest active and Frozen Ground. So, you know, just going for a simple Malakai fight. I do appreciate that as well for a change. Brandus, that's of course never a bad thing. Yeah, just beyond in if for Malakai, not entirely sure with things, so zombies and the blood maggots and things like that, whether we can get additional demon spawns in the Malakai fight, but it doesn't sound like a good idea to actually have them there. But Brandus will just suck at that one at least. Talisman. Sure. Not that. Yeah, we do need more talismans. Even if it's just for potential for the achievements. Now I need to kill 5 different tier 3 talisman unique things. So getting some more talismans to sacrifice them to the talisman gods seems useful. So at this point it is a little bit of a long shot. Okay, I think we should just go up rather than sideways. Though if this is anything like the previous area, then I might come to regret making this specific decision. Managed to include the rare just by stretching it far enough. sideways. Okay, so far so good. We often get a thing like this just before the piety fight. The directionality is good at least. Whoop. Okay, that's backwards. Open storms slightly further and then just retreating. It is nice because you basically get to remotely place it that way. And we're breaking again into the wrong direction. I think it's up there. So let's backtrack this way. And then test the piety. Destroyer Regalia is a tier down from what I've currently got, so probably not gonna be all that great. So let's push up a fort. Haha, the power of beasts. Right. We have two golems, they are both at full strength. We have everything maxed out, so let's do this. Piety.
It's not often we get to erase our failures.
Okay, and we just stack against you. Another hit for 10. Bubble storms, totem, walk, 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 walk. Hit you for 10. Hit you for 10, and you're dead. Okay, bye bye.
Our mistakes can be our greatest achievements. Okay.
Let's just empty our pockets, pick up some stones, and then move forward. So, piety was once again an easy fight. Which, oh, it is nice. Beyond, that's for level 66. Let's see. I don't really care much about Rampage, but sure, we'll grab it. We... Warband. Let's just grab something pretty simple as a ambush. Actually do that instead of the talisman like that. Right. Then it is time to head towards Malakai himself and end this once and for all. But before that, let's refresh our golems, because they look a little pale.
Good. I like surprises.
Okay, that's a rare there. One hit, down for 2/3. That's not quite bad. If it had ignited the rare would have died from the ignite. Another one just dies in a single hit. It depends a little bit on the health, on the mods, on other things like, you know, is elemental equilibrium active on the mob or not. Ooh, gem cutter, strongbox, I appreciate those. Couple more mobs in the back, and there you are. And we got the gem cutter. Maybe I should pick up the shrine, that's what was it. Aspect of violence. Ah, that's part of the rampage mod for the map. We get some weapons. Sure, it's more things to kill. Wonder if we kill enough zombies in the final fight with Malakai. Do we get the? And we actually do get some rampage bonuses as well. If we just keep chaining zombie kills. But today's not a good day to be a zombie. Not sure if there's ever a good day to be a zombie, but probably today is not gonna be. Okay, and we got Chevron of Umbra as the first one.
I shall preserve your beauty for eternity. So pretty.
Too early.
So pretty.
And then final one. Push. You're good. You're gone. And now we are up some entrails.
Glad I won't be seeing any more of your work.
Okay. So that was the first one. So I might report back and use the waypoint to get to town. And of course, to empty pockets. Take some entrails. I know you want them. Okay, some other little things. I will most definitely not miss having to rerun all of these quests over and over and over again. Once 3.0 hits the live service. Though part of me will miss that this is gonna be the hardest content of the game, because for a long time it has been. Ever since the Awakening expansion, which was in the middle of 2015, that's quite a while ago. Ever since then, this has been the endgame content, the toughest, the story-based endgame content. Of course, maps and Shaper, things like that are the true endgame, but as far as the story is concerned, Act 4 has always been the end. And Merciless Malakai was, something that was quite a challenge to actually do. Something I usually pushed back until I had my character at least somewhere in the 80s. In fact, I still need to kill him in this league. Just because there's a lot of damage in those mines, especially on Merciless. Luckily, we're only on Cruel, so difficulty is going to be toned down a little bit. But first, Inquisitor Malagaro. Let's refresh our columns again and go into the fight.
Exquisite.
Let's just give you a. Accent.
Sculpted.
I hate to be critical, but I've seen better.
So the let's give you without actually saying a word, that was a reference to the lightning trap. Lightning trap, 50% increased damage taken. Combine that with a max flame blast. Now you're doing a lot of pain. Now you are inflicting a lot of pain upon your unsuspecting foe. One of the nice things of having a bit of life regen as well as energy shield is that if you've taken a couple of scratches on your life but your energy shield is fully charged, then you don't even need to drink a healing potion in order to just get your life maxed out without it really being an issue that it is not maxed. De Wedre, you are next, or last, depending on how you want to look at it. Okay, she's on fire, that is good. And yeah. There you go. Bye bye.
Okay. Oh, Doedry. We witches have to have some standards.
There's not even a need to perform a killing spree on the way back. Because we do have our maxed out flame trap or lightning trap with 3 charges. So we can simply go down and face down Mr. Malachi. We are level 58. So this is definitely seems to be a fair fight. So let's do this. Okay, there you go, that's 1 shot, that's 2 shots, that's 3 shots. Okay, that was first stage, and then whoosh, whoosh again. Oop. Let's not do that, shall we? Prefer to stay alive rather than dying. Okay, Malachi is at half his life. Keep stepping on those mines, that's maybe not the best of ideas. But in the end, Malachi is dead. Piety is dead. She's truly dead, right? Yeah, I think so. So that takes us to the. Let's just fix that flask and then go in. Malachi, you're mine.
Now, let us see if you truly understand what it means to be Nightmare.
Okay, you are hostile, so burn. Ooh, nice, we got a burn off. That's a nice opening. First heart. I like it. Okay. So far so good. See if we can use. Okay, the golems are going down pretty quickly. Okay, lost lightning golem. That's good because that one is still active. So we can simply just recast it. Second heart. It's gone, that's one more. Okay, he's gonna port in, that means he's predictable, means we can just wait for him. Let's just do a little bit of mind sweeping here. Totems are great for that. Okay, dodge that one. One more explosion here. It's another one. Good thing about being arranged is that we don't necessarily have to be next to the thing to trigger it. Oh, I just spotted that one from the edge. Oh, that was indeed. Spotted it too late that he ported on top of me while I was too focused on minesweeping, but doesn't really matter. He's nearly dead. Well, that's it, of course. Nearly is not good enough. He actually needs to be dead before I can finally be at rest. Until then, let's stay vigilant. Okay, there you go, there you go. Okay, he's gonna be here. That means we can charge against him. And yeah, there we are. He's gone. Took a bit of a risk in the end there, because he was tentacling against me, but already was at like 5 or 6 charges, so figured finishing it, blowing up, and killing him was the right call.
Poor Malachi, he was so frightened of death, weren't you?
One of the downsides of this build is two different golems and not having enough buttons to keep juggling those. I never really used the decoy totem, so what I could do is go with that, but then if I no figure I really need a decoy totem now, then I don't have one, so yeah, it's a difficult choice. But Malakai lies dead. That means Cruel has been completed. Next episode is gonna be the Labyrinth. Because of course, after Malakai always follows the Labyrinth. But that is gonna be next episode. So as always, thank you very much for watching. And I hope to see you again next time. Bye bye.